we're really concerned that potentially the majority of the global burden of disease over the next century is going to result from our impacts across our planet's natural systems.
What we found were 5 to 10% reductions in nutrients like iron, zinc, and protein.
What's been viewed for decades as a growing environmental crisis really needs to be viewed as also a growing public health crisis.
It all depends on what we decide to do right now today. That's the urgency of now. We are at that inflection point. So it depends on our own choices in this generation.
We tend to look at these as individual problems, their productivity, their profit, their social problems, and planetary health kind of shines a bright light on the fact that they're all directly connected to each other.
Sam Myers has been one of the global leaders in the field of planetary health, so aggregating many global databases, paying attention not just to the quantity of food, but to the quality of food, quantitatively analyzing which populations around the world will be threatened in terms of which particular nutrient supplies and what the health impacts will be.
If we'd sat around 15 years ago and said, I wonder how dumping carbon dioxide into the atmosphere will affect our nutritional status, we probably wouldn't have thought that CO2 would reduce the nutrient content of staple food crops. How do we understand this transformation? So I do my own research, which is sort of small pieces of the jigsaw puzzle, and then I support the growth of the Planetary Health Alliance, which is trying to build up the entire global community that's doing research on many of the other pieces of the same jigsaw puzzle and trying to support the growth of this sort of emerging field of planetary health.
You know, we have high quality science in individual disciplines, but he managed to put together four different disciplines, and the papers that they published out of that, that's the example that we should be looking at.
The positive vision is right there for us to see.